What's going on, YouTube? This is Big Juan Robles, aka Stan Nelson, with Top Deck Gaming, and we are bringing you another Naruto CCG deck profile today featuring Xenosis 619. So, without further ado, let's get on to the deck build.
Alright, so I call this deck Shadow Intelligence. It's a shadow deck based around the Nara clan. So, let's get into that. First off, Choji. Best friends, Burning Fist here. When this ninja's battling and Lightning Ninja, Senji gets +2 during the turn and is unaffected by Lightning Ninja effects. This is in here, one, so I can squat out at some point if I need to, but also because Lightning has some anti-mental stuff that's usually pretty early game, and then I can dispatch those pretty quickly with this card, with the power gain and, you know, any other support, since I have a lot of support in this deck. So, good card to start with. Two Shikamaru Childhoods. This one is the one when it's put in play or removed from play, you can move three cards from your discard pile top of your deck and shuffle. Then when this ninja, you know, is moved to your chakra area by the effect of growth, you can place an additional growth coin on a ninja. So I like this because I'm always going to end up growthing into a better Shikamaru. And then, you know, having that ability, if I lose cards quick by Wind Scythe or, you know, maybe training in the Moonlight or something like that, when it leaves that play, I'm going to be able to put those cards back and, you know, hopefully get them again. So definitely helpful in the deck. Great starter. Meant Power 3. Yeah. Two of each of the Village Elders here. These do the same thing when they're battling against a ninja with a team. Mental Power 1 or less becomes a Mental Power battle. So these are a great stall because they are turn 0, they have Mental Power 2 each. Great stall, great way to, you know, kind of keep your opponent at bay for, you know, usually about 2 turns. even though they don't have stats themselves, you know, good cards in their own, and definitely help out to get everything out later on that I need. Next up, one of my favorite cards, Shio here. Mental Power 2. During the mission phase, you can draw one card, then move one card from the top of your deck to your, or from your hand to the top of the deck. This is great setup. It helps me out a lot, and I don't have to, say, you know, switch out an entire hand like I would have to with, you know, soccer and things like that. Because it's usually I don't want to do that. So this combo is great with some other cards that let me draw, and then, you know, I end up netting that card back to my hand anyways, so definitely one of my favorites, great card for this deck. Two Yoshinos here. As a mother, when you have another Nara on the field, this ninja gets +3 mental power, and when it's battling with another Nara, it becomes a mental power battle. This helps set up early game. If I have Shikamaru Childhood out, your opponent's already going to stall for at least 2 to 3 turns, depending if they run something that's heavy mental or not. Also, later game, when I have, you know, my perfect Shikamaru team set up, you just set this on the side with Shikaku, and, you know, it gives you a pretty decent mental power battle that can really help out a lot. Definitely has Chunin also. Definitely helps with you know, certain shadow jutsus for different turns and different reasons. So, good card for this deck. Two Sakura Book Smarts. Comes into play and draws a card, and then you, when you deploy any other ninjas with Mental Power 2 or more, you also draw a card. This combo is great with pretty much the entire deck. KNS comes in, draw and reveal, draw for Sakura, and you end up, you know, especially if you happen to growth KNS in a turn, it just, you end up netting a lot of cards, and then you might draw a card in a mission, student sensei, something like that. You're getting all those cards. It's a great way to replenish your hand. Good mental power, decent turn, decent power. Definitely helpful. Next up, ever popular Konohamaru Ninja Squad. Put in play. Reveal the top card of your deck, put it in your hand. Other leaf ninjas cannot be affected by opponent's ninjas. This is great. A lot of my ninja effects aren't valid, so it helps in the process of keeping them healthy. if your opponent likes to use some sort of effect that gets rid of ninjas or, you know, injures ninjas or something along those lines, this keeps people on the field, it keeps people alive, you know. So, definitely a good card to have. One of my favorites. Two Eno Playfuls. Each player can only put in play one ninja per turn, and effect text to your opponent's head ninjas are negated. This is great to use. Usually somebody with a powerful head ninja has a good effect. Something like the Neji that, you know, give a damage or your opponent discards a card, stuff like that. You know, you want to keep your opponent at bay. You want to keep them, you know, hurting and trying to figure out different ways to play that maybe they're not used to. So, Eno Playful, so many good Eno effects. This is just one of my favorites. Also, they, you know, with the one ninja per turn thing that they can't exceed, they have to, you know, decide if they want to put a card in play or they want to put a reinforcement or a squad, and then they're done. They can't do anything else. They wouldn't be able to do the three different things that they would normally do. It takes them longer to set up while you're already set up and going for the win. So, you know, Playful, great card, one of my favorites, good mental power, growth, definitely helpful. The Shikamaru here, the deck's mostly based around quick thinking. When you have a combined mental power of 10 or more in this ninja's team, uses its mental power value instead of its team power during the showdown. So it doesn't mean it's a mental power battle, it just means that if I have a mental team power of 10 or more, that is now my team power. Other ninjas also get plus 1 mental, so on turn 2, it's very common for me to have a team power of 12. Just based on mental power, Shikamaru, Eno, as a mother, stuff like that, Yoshino, you know, all those add up and give me great power. Gotten a team power 26 with this deck before, so it's very effective, fun to use. This one, Protector of the Will, Shikamaru. Target ninja you control cannot be the target of jutsu cards with a name symbol after paying the two earth chakra there. Very helpful, especially late game when I don't need quick thinking anymore, opponent's hurting, and I have everything set up perfectly right. Can growth out into this one, or if I maybe can't get into any of the other ones, this is definitely a good one to have. Has that little bit of pseudo negation too, which definitely helps. And with growth, you know, anything's possible. So the almighty Chiriku here. This ninja has an 8 combined mental power. Oh, well, I have ninjas with 8 combined mental power. This ninja's team is unaffected by opponent's jutsus. This combo with, you know, Shikamaru in the back and K&S in the back, you know, it definitely helps. It makes everything really great. It keeps people alive, keeps people healthy, and, you know, without being able to be affected by jutsus, you know, a lot of people, they don't have a game plan for that. So definitely very helpful. Shikaku has a father here. Shikamaru's in play. He has health. He gets 4 mental power. And then while this ninja's in the same team as Shikamaru, it becomes mental power battle. This is great if maybe I'm hurting all game and I have those two out. It starts letting me get back, you know, hitting that 8 mental power with whatever cards else I have on the field. You know, starts getting back into the game. Jonin uses all my shadow jutsus in here. You know, keeps the shadow aspect alive. Two Osmos Fist Fury. Earth ninjas get plus 2 mental power, and when a team of mental power of 10 or more win any victory, you win a battle award. So essentially that could mean any turn you're winning battle awards regardless if your opponent blocks or not. Definitely helpful. Also squads into Shikamaru, Osmo platoon or squad, you know, afterwards or something along those lines. But definitely, when I have a good amount of ninjas on the field, this effect makes everything a lot better and helps you win games. Yamato here. Planning during your exchange jutsu. If you have ninjas with a combined of mental power 12 or more, move one jutsu or mission card from your discard pile to your hand. That keeps your hand healthy, keeps, you know, if you need cards, take a mission card, lets you draw something along those lines. You know, do things like that. Keeps your hand good. You know, keeps your opponent on their toes too, because you're always getting something back every turn during the exchange jutsu. It doesn't matter whose turn it is. Very helpful to have. Great card. Last ninja, first Hokage Supremacy. When it's deployed, you get two your opponent's battle rewards to your hand, and during the mission phase, you can shuffle four cards from your discard pile to your deck. This is great if you're playing a mill deck, you're keeping those cards in the deck because it can be used, you know, every turn. And then getting those two cards back to your hand is great too, just simply because your opponent's down two battle rewards, and you know, certain decks might not really need them, but you know, sometimes you're just going to get those back in your hand, and it works well. Has mastery, mental power, helps out a lot. On to jutsus here, thinking mode. I really like this card. It only costs one earth. It's just requirements of mental power one or more, which is essentially every card in the deck. Look at all the cards in your opponent's hand and draw a card. I get to net a card to my hand, and I get to look at my opponent's hand. That helps me kind of set up a battle plan. You know, what do they have? What do I need to have to counter that or to continue to push on that instance? So this is a card I like a lot. It helps me set up for my entire game. Two palms rotations. Every ninja in the user's team cannot be affected by opponent's ninja effects and jutsus during this turn. Then it does have expert Byakugan, can't receive damage. I don't have any Byakugan users, but that pseudo negation is something that is great for me to have. That keeps my ninjas healthy, or on, at least on the field even, and helps all my things go off correctly. Super cheap to use, a lot of, you know, can be used in any deck also. Great card. Two Shikamaru's Judgments. Good thing about this card is when Shikamaru is using it, it cannot be affected by your opponent's effects. Requirements leave for tuning. You get to select one of the two, negate jutsu, move it to the top of the owner's deck, or remove a mission from the game. I keep this in here because it can't be affected if Shikamaru is using it, which means opponent can't say, you know, let's change this effect, or, you know, something along those lines, or even negate it. and then you can get rid of a mission card. If your opponent has a permanent X or a permanent mission that's just killing you, something along the lines of, you know, next target or, you know, was it comparative strengths, this gets rid of that and gets you back in the game. Can be used as soon as turn one with Yoshino, so definitely helpful and keeps everything going. Two Howls. I was at a tournament recently, and I was really surprised a lot of people didn't use this card. One ninja battling against the user, target becomes a standby. Simple to use, two earth or three, anything can be used in any deck. Your opponent tries to use a jutsu, standby, they're no longer using that jutsu. So pseudo negation in itself, drop team power, you know, definitely helps you back. And once an opponent becomes a standby during the exchange jutsu, they can't come back in unless used probably by a jutsu card. So definitely helpful, works really well, easy to use. You know, opponent tries to chump block with a single target, you know, that's battle rewards instead. So it definitely works. Shadow Stitching. I really, really like this card. Requirements, shadow with an interest cost of two or more. So it's kind of costly. Yoshino can't use it, unfortunately. But one ninja opposing user remove the target from the game. Your opponent can draw two cards if they want to. I like this card. It can be used early with Shikamaru. And it can hurt somebody all game. They're trying to set up for, you know, a certain Naruto or a certain this or a certain that, and you end up getting rid of that, you know, with all the other pseudo negation. So somebody's leaving the field, and that's a good thing to have, especially because it's removed from game. So definitely helpful. Interrogation. I like this card a lot. One, I'm a big fan of the gold lettering. Every ninja opposing the user, the target becomes a standby ninja if its mental power is less than the user's. Considering Shikamaru has one of the highest mental powers in the game, this will pretty much work on almost every ninja in the game, minus what, Chikamatsu and the turn zero Yamato. No, turn zero.
Kabuto. 5 mental.
Yeah, with 5 mental. The the set 28 one. So that's pretty much all you're gonna, you know, unless they have some sort of beefiness with, you know, training in Hinata or something like that. But, you know, this is gonna make every opponent, you know, stand by. It's only three costs. It's three anything. So if I have a win card or a lightning card in my chakra, I'm just gonna get rid of that. I haven't really had a chance to use it yet because it is a new edition. Because I recently found it, wanted it really bad, so I put it in here. But I'm hoping it sets up to be pretty useful. On to missions here. Intellectual strategy. Beginning your battle phase, if your ninja's combined mental is 8 or more, you can draw a card. Permanent 3. Turn 1. For me, that's a card every turn. Right before my battle phase. Maybe I'll draw into a jutsu I need. Who knows? But having that almost guaranteed draw every turn, very helpful. Works really well. Next up, Student Sensei. Pretty much a staple in Earth decks now. Give your opponent a battle word, you draw two cards. It's a turn one. I end up getting a battle word back, you know, with the first in this deck anyways. Doesn't really hurt me too much. Getting those two cards, though, can set me up for the entire game. So, I mean, draw cards, it's where it's at. Next up is Nara Clan. Shadow Ninjas get +1/+1. And +2 mental power, it is permanent. And during the exchange of Jutsu, target Shadow Ninjas and opposing team perform a mental power battle during this turn. Having that +2 mental power is one of those things I get up to the 20s in team power with that Shikamaru. And having that extra effect means I don't have to run too many things like cheating or, you know, emergency meeting or something like that. So this card's great, keeps him buffy, and, you know, if all else fails, meant to fire battle. So, last for missions here, Shogi match. During this turn, all teams perform mental power battle. Players must send out their teams out to battle if possible. At the end of the turn, draw one card for each of your teams that won a victory or an outstanding victory during this turn. A lot of people don't run mental. They don't expect it. So using a card like this, I end up with three teams. I might only win regular victories, but I'm probably going to draw three cards at the end of this turn, or at least two. And it forces your opponents to block, which is, I mean, fantastic in itself also. I mean, if they end up having just a team, a field of, you know, single ninjas in a team by themselves, I mean, it's going to thin it out a little bit, but you're getting rid of somebody or you're hurting somebody with this card. You know, indirectly, but in itself. So, good card, and I like the art on it. Next up, let's go with my squads here. So, two Shikamaru Asumas. It's a good card. Ninja cannot be affected by the effects of your opponent's ninjas. Ninja's team wins a victory, outstanding victory. You win one battle reward and draw one card. Hits that team mental power up to 5. Hits ridiculous amounts of support. And it's, I mean, a decent attack also. I like this card a lot. I don't use it too often unless I really have to. You know, if things aren't working out, if I don't have any of my other Naras out, this is my go-to. Getting that battle reward pretty much, you know, every turn, you know, you don't have to wait until somebody no longer has a way to block. So this is definitely a good card to use. Uses that shit awesome effect. But, you know, sometimes you don't have those ninjas out if you're just having a bad game, so this is definitely a lifesaver. So good card for that. I have two different Shikamaru Choji platoons. This one here is the one that when it's battling as attacker, your opponent's ninjas battling against it are negated. And while it's a blocker, it can block up to 2 teams, and you put a growth coin when it blocks. So this thing can get really big. It can really help out if, you know, you're kind of low on ninjas and your opponent's trying to rush you a little bit. You block those teams, and, you know, usually those teams aren't too high, so you don't have to worry about the stacking of the team powers either. And it's getting those coins also. So great card to have, especially with the effect text negated for attacking. This one here, it lets me remove from game a ninja card that includes Shikamaru and or Choji from my reinforcement deck, and then it gets +3/+3 and +3 mental power. This one's a turn earlier, has a little bit less stats on the healthy, but it's, you know, an extra power on this. It's just kind of in there. Sometimes I like to use it because I like the art. Sometimes I just, you know, end up not using it at all. But it's just in there, you know, just to have my choices.
You really like the aesthetic of it all.
Yeah. Side deck here. This is recently the card I took out for, what was it? Interrogation. It was in there, just, you know, extra aspect for having that mental power battle. I really wanted emergency meeting, which is one earth, one anything, or one wind, one anything, so I can get rid of those lightning cards out of my chakra area, since I do have a few of those. Just performs mental power during the turn. I kind of found out that after a while I really don't need this card, but I used to use this a lot in my very first mental deck, you know, six, seven years ago, so... you know, sort of a nostalgia thing. Next up, Shino. Silence, your opponent can't search cards. This is just a great card. It has mental power, it has growth, it's a decent turn. And, you know, certain decks just search for everything. Reliance deck or, you know, any lightning deck, really. So you're going to really hurt somebody by not being able to search for those cards, which is a great, you know, counter to have. Second Eno. This one heals. Discard one Earth Chakra in that case. Heal one injured ninja in this ninja's team. There's so many Enos with good effects. I used to have another set of Enos in here too. But I finally took them out. This one, just in case I'm getting hurt by a lot of burn cards that I just for some reason can't stop or can't seem to get things out to help stop them. I'm going to throw this card in instead and hopefully, you know, keep things from happening. Or at least, you know, let him get hurt, heal it, you know, end up, you know, hitting out at the end of the battle. So, this one does have one less month power than the Eno I have in my deck. But, I mean, it heals, so definitely helpful. Compared to strengths... This is only sideboarded because honestly, if you can't get past an effect, then you kind of need to try harder to find some sort of you know, strategy to do so. this is in here just a sideboard, just in case there's something that I've never seen before that's really hurtful. Something like was it Sakura or Sasuke Exhaustion? I recently fought against that, and that was a pain. So that would be definitely something I would actually use this for, but, you know, sometimes people just pop it for no reason, and, you know, it might hurt them for a turn, but, you know, sometimes it might not even be used. So that's why it's sideboarded, just in case there's something there that I definitely can't see. But, I mean, now that I actually play with some sort of, you know, ban list and rule list and stuff, they already took care of all the ones that I would actually use it for, so, you know, it's just there. Next up, next target. This one is a permanent. During the mission phase, you can move this in-play mission to your chakra area in that case. Negate, discard one mission or being played, or discard one in-play client. Sometimes clients can break a game. You know, there's not too many that can, but, you know, sometimes they're definitely really good. So this is sort of sideboarded for that. And, you know, you keep this or there, it keeps your opponent wondering if they actually want to play a mission or not. So they may never play a mission just because this card's on the field, and, you know, then they're hurting themselves one way or another. Or if they're brave enough, they'll try to actually play a mission too. You know, get rid of it, and then the next turn, you know, finally get into another one, but who knows, you might get the next one by then. So, good setup card, sideboarded, because I really like the way my deck runs, and this kind of doesn't go with it. But it's there if I need it. Alright. So that is Shadow Intelligence. Runs off of Shadow Cards. Any ideas, let me know. If you have any ideas on something that might work better, you know, something along those lines. If you don't like Mental Power, you should probably look into it. It's a lot of fun to use. A lot of people don't like it.
Super annoying to play against.
Super annoying to play against. But once I discovered this Shikamaru Quick Thinking, I changed the entire outlook on how this deck played and made it more of a shadow cards with that Mental Power, you know, backup in case I needed it. And, you know, I've liked it a lot more, and people aren't as annoyed anymore either, so...
Awesome. So that was Zenosis 619 with his Shadow Intelligence deck. And, you know, just to reiterate what he said, you know, we're always looking for suggestions. We're always looking for people who have a different insight on just how to play the game. And we're always open to those critiques. So definitely let us know what you guys thought about it in the comments below. And make sure you like and subscribe to the channel so you guys never miss any content that we put out. We are trying to perfect our game on this, and you know, we can only get better through the help of others. So, and you know, just real quick, if there's anybody out there that wants to see a specific type of deck build or style, let us know. We have, what is it, 20 plus decks?
Yeah,
you have 20 plus decks built already. The way me and Zenosis play, you know, we're different types of players. We don't really play on the meta, and we try to take a different approach to the way that we design decks because we just want to be different. But yeah, again, let us know what you guys thought. Definitely like and subscribe. And to all of those keeping the Naruto CCG dream alive, we salute you. Big one out.